continue. This is the last part of this particular module, the fourth module. We have two categories in this. One is the expectation maximization algorithm, and another one is called as a K-means algorithm. Okay. Now, earlier algorithm or earlier lecture, what you had seen was about the Bayesian belief network. So there we had seen that why we came up with this concept of Bayesian belief network when we want to find out the values of unobserved variables. So this is an extension of the same thing. EM algorithm, it is an iterative method, an iterative method to find the maximum likelihood hypothesis in case of unobserved variables. Okay. Now let's see how we are going to go about this. Supposing I have, I have say 100 phones with me, and I have the price of these 100 phones. Now there are two categories of phones in this. One is a smartphone and one is a normal phone. I have to find out to which category each phone belongs to. That is my job. Okay. So what do I have over here? I have 100 phones. The price of these 100 phones are there. Okay. So I am going to plot a graph over here. I have some the price of these phones. Now randomly I will take 50 phones and draw a Gaussian curve. So I will take 50 phones and draw a Gaussian curve. Another 50 phones and another Gaussian curve. So this is my Gaussian or normal distribution. We have seen this earlier. So a Gaussian distribution is a bell-shaped curve. Okay, now randomly I have taken 50 values, drawn one curve, another 50 values, and I have drawn another curve. What is my job now? I have to take each value and check if it belongs to the first Gaussian or the second Gaussian. Okay, now in case I have put this value as belonging to the first Gaussian, but when I compute, when I apply normal distribution, we find that it belongs to the second Gaussian. Then I have to recompute my mean. How have I taken the mean? First, these many values together will become my mean 1. These many values together will become my mean 2. So here, I have assumed that standard deviation is same, but mean is different. Okay? Now here, if the first value, my assumption was first value falls into Gaussian 1. But in case, after computation, I find it falls into Gaussian 2. Then I have to recompute my mean, because I have computed the mean of this curve with all these values. But now I find that this value belongs to this point. Then I have to recompute mean for this and for this. So again I will recompute and I am going to find for the next value. So this way the process goes on and on until we filter or divide all the values into two different sets. That is what we do in our Gaussian or expectation maximization algorithm. Two important steps: find the expected value, that is the first value what I get, the mean value. And then step two is calculate the maximum likelihood hypothesis. When I talk about maximum likelihood hypothesis, I am talking about the minimum error. So that is why we have computed here ML, the maximum likelihood hypothesis is the minimum error, which is the data minus the mu. Okay, the whole square, because we are taking square of the error. So once I get this, my mean will be new mean. Okay, the new mean will be summation of all the values divided by n. That means initially assume I had 10 values. Now one value goes to this. So what will the new mean will be? All these values, 9 values divided by 9. That is the maximum likelihood hypothesis, which are the two stages of your expectation maximization algorithm. So here again, what am I trying to do? For each value of xi, okay, these are my xi values. So for each value of xi, I am computing the mean. And why we have taken 2 is because we have assumed there are 2 Gaussians. And this is nothing else but the formula of normal distribution, which we have dealt with earlier. E to the power of minus 1 by 2 sigma squared into xi minus mu whole squared. Okay, so this is, since we are considering a normal curve or a Gaussian curve, we substitute those values, the formula for a normal distribution, to compute your expectation value. So here I assume each point as belonging as a triplet, xi, z1, Gaussian, Z2 is your second Gaussian. So I have to determine if the value of xi belongs to the first Gaussian or the second Gaussian. Iteratively we will keep doing this until all the values are being split. So that is about your, that is your expectation maximization algorithm.
Okay, so I hope this much is clear to you so far. What are the expectation maximization algorithm?
Okay, another algorithm in this is called as your k-means algorithm. Here, the new mean will be 1.96, which we will, sorry, 19.6, which we will round to 20. Okay? Again, now find which clusters that belong to. So, K1 is equal to 2 is closer to 5, 3 is closer to 5, 4 is closer to 5, 10 is closer to 5, 11 also is closer to 5. 11 minus 5 is 4, 11 minus 20 is 9. 11 also is closer to 5, 12 is closer to 5. Okay? Then here, K2 is equal to the remaining numbers, which is 20, 25 and 30. Okay? Now again, recompute your mean. Once again, when I compute, I get M1 equal to 7 and M2 equal to 25. Okay? Find the clusters. So I get K1 equal to 2, 3, 4, 10, 11, 12. K2 equal to 20, 25, 30. Okay? Now when I compute my mean, I will again get the same mean. M1 equal to 7, M2 equal to 25. So here we find that we have got the same mean here and here. Clusters are also the same. So this becomes my final cluster set. Okay? So at this point we will stop the algorithm. Now this is a simple data set what we have. A small variation of this we will just see. Okay?
Values do not change and the mean also should not change.
K means, the question is you have to divide the data into two clusters. It is already given you. Divide the data into two clusters using your K means algorithm. Okay? Hope you have understood. So that completes the fourth module. Almost have covered everything. So if there are any clarifications, you can use that. Thank you.